The mirror itself was always going to be the most complicated and challenging character to pull off in this movie. It is an inanimate object. It just hangs on a wall. So making sure that that mirror was not just going to be a prop was always tough. And one of the things that was really exciting for me was that because this was a movie monster that you could pick up and take to a completely different place, and it opened up the mythology to just kind of endless possibilities.
This object is responsible for at least 45 deaths in the 4 centuries of its recorded existence.
Being able to kind of trace it through history and move it around to different countries and have pockets where no one knew where it was, where, you know, there are stories that are just lost to time, victims who will never know. That stuff was just delicious from a writing point of view.
Philip Lazar was found at their grand fireplace, burned beyond recognition.
The idea was that the way the mirror would interact with someone should be as specific and individual as their own reflection, you know, that it would find its way into someone's psyche based on where the natural weak points were, so no one would have the same experience.
The woman died of thirst while soaking in a full tub for 3 days.
If it's a piece of evil that turns your worst perceptions, fears, and insecurities back on you.
Clancy apparently weighed over 300 pounds. Later that year, Robert Clancy is photographed by a local newspaper, and he's dropped a few pounds.
Karen Gillan came in with 13 pages of monologue, essentially, that people were very concerned that this would be very boring. Do we need to shoot these stories and flash back to them and kind of show these horrific events? And the hope was that no. Something that I have always believed is that a viewer's imagination is going to be able to come up with something way more effective and frightening than we can.
3, 2, 1.